Okay, let's get right to the build. This is for shipment number 15. We got 55, 56, 57, and 58. So let's put the other issues aside. See, what we're going to do first is we're going to put 55A onto the top of the primary hull. So that would be this part. Look at NCC 1701D. And this is where landing bay number one is. Let's see, that's going to be FM screws, and it's going to be six. So we got our FM screws. There we go. Looking pretty nice. All right, what's next? All right, so we're going to get the bridge section and we're going to run the wires through. And that's going to have a ton of screws holding it in place. 14 BM screws to start with. All right, that's looking good. And now what we got to do is we got to take the circuit board out so we can put the rest of the screws in. All right. Put that there and you can see where we're going to put some more screws in. There's a lot of screws in this section. Okay, now we need to put the circuit board back. So we need two more FM screws to secure the circuit board. So okay. So you can see all the screws are in. The circuit board is back in place. So let's flip it over, look at the top. You can see the beautiful Enterprise. Look at that, huh? All right, so that's set. That's all set. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna do the impulse engines. All right. Again, I might have to bring it back just a bit. So that is going to be for this side, and that will be the port. You can see it's going to go just like that. You can see the beautiful red lens. And take the left saucer impulse engine and a left impulse reflector. It's going to be this. You can see where the bulb is going to go. Then locate the deck panel lights fitted in stage 50. Ah, here it is. And this is going to go, you can see where it's going to go in. The little bulb is going to, there's a little a slot. And that's going to be held in place with AP screws, just to get it in place. All right, so just make sure it's holding on. Let's get the other one ready, and then we'll put the bulb in. You can see how the bulb is going to hold it in place, the screw, but it's not terribly secure. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a piece of tape just in case. Just to keep it from falling out with handling. And when we go to put the other half, or when we complete the bottom section, I'll take the tape off before sealing it. But I just want to make sure that that doesn't come off. Okay, we're going to do the same thing for the other side. So we need more AP screws. Two more. And we have the other light that they were talking about. And that's going to go on this side. Just like that. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing to hold the lens in place. A little bit of tape. And then when we put the bottom piece, the bottom panel on, we'll take it off. I just don't want it going anywhere. So just like that for now, just to keep it in place. All right, you guys can see we've got the impulse engines on. They're in place, the light bulbs are in, and looks like we're going to put this aside for now and we're going to move on. All right, moving on to step E, you can see we've got that piece that's going to go into the nacelle with the switch. And you can see we're going to put the nut into the cap, and then we're going to put the cap on with two AP screws. You can see where the bolt is going to go in. Just like that. Now we're going to add the cap. Don't want to tighten them too much. Don't want to strip it. Well, there we go. So now we're going to take stage 56 assembly. Nice. Looks like we're going to put on the phaser arrays. So we're going to hold these in place with the CP screws. You can see all the CP screws. We'll get those ready. We've got one with a rounded edge. So that's going to go there. Just like that. And this is going to bring this section together. Nope, that's not for that section. It's probably for this side. So that's going to go just like that. This one's going to go here. Okay. Just like that. So we're going to be putting them in place with the CP screws. So I just wanted to fit them first. All right, there's one. Let's put the next section in. That will be this section, right? Okay, so now we'll put this one in. All right, let's take a look at what we got. Okay, so you can see the phaser array is going in nicely. All right, so we got the next small part. Okay, now we're up to this section. And we got one more piece of the phaser array. And it's going to go in right like that. Look at that. Nice. We got the phaser array in. We've got the transporter emitters. We've got the escape pods. We got the impulse engine in. We got the bridge in. We got all the windows in. So looking pretty good so far. Let's see what's next. Okay, now we're going to put the port in starboard. Okay. Push the red formation light into the position in the aft port side. There. And that's going to get pushed into position just like that. I'm wondering if I should just put a little tiny little piece of tape just to secure it. We don't want that popping out. And you can see the other side is going to go right there. Just like that. Let's see if you guys can see the starboard green and the port red. And we're going to get the Bessard collector part we were working on with the switch. And we're going to take the bottom of the Bessard collector itself. Absolutely beautiful. All right, what are we going to do? We're going to actually put that into this section, and we're going to use the GM screws. You see it's going to click into place just like that. So why don't we go ahead, and we're going to put the screws in. The GM screws. And it looks like the switch is going to go in this way. And that's going to be held in place with DM screws. You can see the switch is in. All right. You can see pushing it back is going to be off. Pushing it forward is going to be on. And we're going to take the lock spring and the lock pin. All right, let's. Okay. So the lock pin is going to go right into the spring, and that's done. And that is going to go right in here. You can see how the spring is going to go in, and the pin is going to go towards the center of the nacelle. Okay, so you're going to have the pin itself lying across, and it's going to be coming out of both sides in the grooves, and the spring itself is going to stay in the box. And this is going to go over just like that. That way there, when it's in, you can see it's springy, pushes in and locks into place. So this will lock it to the bottom of the ship. Okay, that's done. So let's move on. And it looks like we're going to use the PC board number 3. All right, we got our circuit board. And FM screws are going to hold it in place. Here we are. Okay, so what's the first thing we're going to hook up? All right, we're going to take this, and this is going to go on the second PC board. I'm going to put it right, let's see, there. And that's going to go in over there. All right, so that'd be giving us power into the third PC board. All right, you guys can see that. Okay, now here comes a lot of fun. Let's see. Now we're going to take the source of power switch and plug it into the socket marked SW1 on PC board number 1. And that's all the way back here. All right, that's in. Now what are we going to do with that? Now the light's 33C, 36H, all slots marked A. Right there. And there's another one coming from right here. Just like that. Okay. And now there's two that it's going to go into C. That's going to go right here. Just like that. And there should be one more that's going to go there. All right, so I'm going to put some zip ties to kind of hold these wires in place. All right, so that's going to hold that in place. Let's plug it in. You've got a tester. And where is that going to go? All right. It looks like everything's lit up, but I'm still missing the section. And if we did it right, this switch, we put it on, we put it off. Okay. Let's flip it over. Check it out. Let's put it on first. Oh, look at that. We've even got the impulse engines lit up. All right. Take your tripod. Look at that, huh? So the switch is working, all the lights are on. You can see the impulse engines. That looks so cool. The bridge area, all the windows, and get a little bit more light. Look at that. Try to get the impulse engines there. Love it. Look at that, guys. Love it. That is absolutely gorgeous. Okay, so now we can flip it back over and we're going to put, now we know the switch is working. If I can find where the switch is now. I just saw the switch. Come on, here it is. It's easy to lose track of that. All right, let's put the switch off. And what's next? All the LEDs in the upper saucer section should now illuminate, and they did. Place the lower skeleton. Okay, so now we're going to start. Taking care not to trap any wires beneath it. Then secure using 4 FM screws and 8 BM screws. So where are the 4 FM? The FMs are going to go along the outer part, and the BM screws are going to go in all the middle ones. Okay, we're going to need a lot of BM screws, so all right. Whew, okay, that's a lot of screwing. All right, now we need the FM screws. And they're gonna go in the outer part. So there's 4 of them. So we got that in. Let's hope this is going to be on the right side. We have to fish that through. Okay, what's next? That was part E. And it looks like we're going to do the push pin or the lock pin for the other side. Start by putting the pin onto the lock pin, the spring onto the lock pin. Just like this. And that's going to go into the box like this. And remember, the just the spring goes into the box. And the pin itself, you're gonna see that it's gonna come on both sides because it's gonna be able to be pushed in to lock it in place. And where's the cover? Here it is. And that's gonna be held in place with AM screws. So let's put that. You can see, I don't know if you can see the bottom where it's going to be able to push through. Just like that. Okay. That's on. And it looks like we're going to put this aside again. Plug the front formation LED 58H into the B socket on Saucer PCB. One. Actually, let's plug it in first. It'll probably be easier. Okay, so this is going to go this way. Now let's feed it through underneath. Take the left aft formation LED. Plug it into the larger of the two slots marked W. On PC board one. So, like this. And we're going to run that through to this way. Now plug the aft starboard LED formation light into the smaller W slot, threading the bulb through the skeleton as shown. That's going to go on the other side. So that's going to go right here. It's just tough to see with all the wires in the way. Plug that in. Okay, and this is going to go all the way around. And now, take one of the two formation LEDs and plug it into either of the two sockets, GR, PC board one. Just like that, and that's going to run through. We're going to go underneath, and we're going to go to the other side. All right, and this one is going to go the same way. All right, now what we got to do is we got to put the other section of the frame on. And that's going to take BM screws and FM. It's going to be 4 FM. The rest are going to be BM. And remember, this is going to go underneath, just like that. And I make sure we're not going to cut any, make sure there are no wires in that area. All right, so let's start putting the screws in. And lastly, we have FM screws, 4 of those. So we got that one in, and what are we going to do next? Slide the saucer panel switch to the on position. The front bottom LED should stay lit while the others should blink. All right, where's the switch? All right, now it should go on. All right, they're not blinking. Oh, here's one. All right, so this one is staying on. That one's going to go there. And we've got, okay, I think it's going to be blinking for the top and the bottoms. So we got 4 blinking. Is that what they're saying? Slide the saucer power switch on. The front formation LED should stay lit. This is staying lit. While the others should all be blinking. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. Let's put the light off and I'll show you what they're talking about. So we actually got it right. You can see it's probably going to be for the top and for the bottom of the navigation lights. And this is going to be in the area of 10 forward. I'll show you guys how pretty cool that looks. And that's everything. Let's put the light back on. And where's the switch? We're going to put this back off. So we got a lot done on the saucer section. We closed off the top side. And we got two sections of the frame on the bottom. And we did some work on the nacelle. And we put the phaser arrays on. That looks pretty cool. It's so big, I actually have to zoom out. See when we zoom in to where it's supposed to be. So, looking forward to more of the build. So, my friends, I thank you so much for watching. And until our build, let's see, it would be shipment number 16. I'll talk to you soon.